name's Liam McBean. I'm playing at Glenelg at the moment. I'm a key forward and I wear number one. Grew up with a footy in my hand from a pretty young age. Bouncing around the backyard, kicking the footy with dad, and then all of a sudden went to Aberfeldy to start my junior career. From then I was scouted by the Calder Cannons in the TAC Cup, and then yeah, progressed through there to the Vic Metro squads. I was able to be a part of the AIS Academy program before then being drafted by Richmond when I was 18. I suppose there's nothing really that can probably describe the culmination of all that sort of hard work and amazing night. I got to experience that sort of really high of highs, and yeah, I was obviously really super grateful to be drafted by the Richmond Football Club. Not being from Adelaide originally, getting an education on the history of the football club before I moved here was a massive appeal. Obviously knowing that Glenelg was such a proud club, really well supported football club, I was really blown away when I came through the facilities and met the players and the pride that they actually had for the footy club and playing for the jumper that we have. I guess we came into that final series feeling like we really didn't have anything to lose. I think it was probably a good thing for us to have to do it the hard way. I think it's a reflection of how a lot of the senior players, particularly in the club, had to fight to really keep the club in a winning position. And I feel like that was the best way we could have done it, was to earn it.
Kicks out wide, and Siren is there. And for the first time in 33 years, the Tigers are kings of the Sample Jungle.
I mean, I remember after we won, walking around the ground and seeing people crying and how much it meant to them, getting messages from fans about how much it meant that we'd been able to achieve what they'd been waiting so long for, and the singing and the dancing, just the actual just genuine enjoyment of what success actually looks like. And I guess now that we've had players that have witnessed that, and you know, there's probably 8 or 9 of us that are still remaining, that's the drive, I guess, to emulate what we were able to achieve in 2019 and to go again, because there's no better feeling than that siren ringing and you're ahead.